good time. Seven.
What's up, guys? So here we are at Adamant Barbell. Today is squat bench day. We got about high volume. We have high volume, moderate intensity today. We have a top set working up to 311, I believe. So yeah, super stoked. First day back on the programming, so let's get it. So, just did three sets of 311 except for the first one. We did 319 instead of 311. That was no bueno. My hips.
Back at Adamant again. It's me, your boy, Rich. Richie Rick.
Fit like Rich. No, I didn't. Anyway, I was recording myself. Anyways, as I was saying, 311, set of three, and then now I'm about to do an end wrap, and I am fucking tired. Like, holy fuck. And you know it's serious too when we pull out the dad hat. If I can find my dad hat.
2 hours later.
We found it, guys.
So I'm gonna do a quick voiceover so you guys aren't just, you know, watching me do my accessory works. But anyways, quick recap on today's workout. Overall, really happy with the way how everything moved. Squats was really good. Felt good really doing that high volume for the first time in a long time. The only thing was I was a little disappointed the way how the AMRAP was. I wanted more than seven. I definitely was shooting for like 8 or 9. Not that I'm making any excuses, but definitely using a squat bar, which is something I wasn't used to. It's a little bit thicker, so having that thicker bar, I don't know, I couldn't get like the bar in position on my back where it needed to be. But yeah, other than that, things were looking really good. Bench was moving really well too. I was really happy with that. It felt really explosive. I was able to utilize leg drive, you know, pin my shoulders down, keep them depressed. Yeah, it was really good. And then as you can see, I'm gonna be doing lunges right now, or have been doing lunges, and then eventually gonna be doing split squats too as well. A tip for my lunges actually that I got from Jeff Nippard's video was try to like lead and try to focus and put all your weight on the front foot, on the front heel, you know, and drive through that. Drive down through the front heel. That's a really good cue that I use to make sure that I'm maintaining proper positioning and, you know, having good form, maintaining proper form. Anyways, moving on. So you'll notice that I'm doing a lot more unilateral accessories, meaning, you know, one-legged movements, you know, such as the lunges and split squats. The reasoning behind that is basically it fixes any muscular imbalances and improves balance. And my right side, my right hip, my right leg is all sorts of fucked. So you'll definitely be seeing me incorporate those a lot more in my blocks. But yeah, so that pretty much is a quick wrap up for this workout. Yeah, I'll see you guys at the next one. All right, bye-bye.
So, day two on the program, we have upper body day. It's focused more on bench. Still in the high volume block, so the load is relatively light. But bench is feeling pretty good so far. Warming up. Day three in the program, we have deadlifts today. It's 84% for a top set of three, and then a 5x5, 70%. So we're still on the high volume block, so it's gonna be like this for another 2 weeks or so. Gotta get acclimated to the volume, but you know, we're just gonna get shit done, you know, no excuses, right? So let's get started.
I guess recap for day three, or for recap for deadlifts. Overall, really happy with the way how the weight's been. I was struggling for the longest time with like the concept of hinging, but when I switched over to conventional, I was able to kind of, I learned how to hinge essentially. Also, thanks to Jared, appreciate that. Taking that month off from sumo, learning like, you know, different cues from conventional, I was able to take what I learned from that 1 month and transfer it over to sumo, and my god, it has translated so well, because my deadlifts have felt so much easier. I'm pulling from a straight back, I'm not squatting my deadlifts, which was a really big issue that I had, and honestly, that's an issue that I see with a ton of lifters actually. Overall, yeah, really happy with that. And as you can see throughout the video here, might have passed already, but I'm doing a lot of hip thrust, hip extension, a lot of that, because that's one of my weak points. Anyways, yeah, so day four and five, as you can see through these clips here, is basically just me doing tempo work and like some bodybuilding stuff. So I kind of just kind of meshed the two together, and I figured it was kind of boring. No one really cares about that. But yeah, day four is generally my tempo work days. So I'll be doing tempo bench and tempo squats. And the thing about tempo is I really like it because it's different than pauses, because it gives you a different cadence. So it's like, instead of just pausing three at the hole or three at the bottom, you know, you use variation. You know, you can slow it on the ascent, or you can slow it down on the descent. Like it's you can mix and match it, and it addresses a lot of sticking points. So for an example, like me, I have a lot of issues with bench on lockout. So especially like, so when you're pushing up the eccentric motion, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, but on that part of the lift, I struggle with that a lot. So like generally, you know, you can have like a pause at the bottom and then explode up, or you can slow it down to like kind of work on any sticking points. It needs a lot of variety in there. And one thing I like about tempo work is that basically it's like that extra day where you can kind of just hone in on your technique, because the weight shouldn't be that heavy. You're working on technique. And for me, I pride myself in being a technical lifter. I don't want to just like muscle through everything. So I want to move the weight as efficiently as possible. So anyways, yeah, that pretty much wraps up for all the workouts for this whole week, essentially. So I kind of just took you through about 5 days worth of powerlifting. So moving on to the next topic at hand, in its programming, why one should program, why you should program or consider, or at least have like a workout regimen plan that's already planned out for you. I feel like that's just so important because one, it keeps you accountable. When you're, you know, having someone write out a program for you, when you're hiring someone, you're spending money, you're spending resources into this, you want to make sure you get the best return possible in your investment. Therefore, you're going to show up to your workouts, you know, you're going to start giving 110% effort, you know, you're going to care about what you eat and stuff like that, because you want, like I said, you want to get the best return possible. And then moving on to my number two, honestly, it makes things just a lot easier. Like, you know, for me, what I mean by easier is like, I'm a relatively busy person, you know, going to grad school, and I'm juggling between like different jobs at a time. So like two or three jobs. And sometimes it's kind of nice to kind of just go on autopilot, not having to worry about it. And of course, this kind of applies to more for powerlifters, or like, and for people who are prepping for competition, as I am. I'm prepping for the Milpitas one in 418. So it's kind of nice just to kind of like be on autopilot and just kind of go in, do your workout, have someone kind of just take care of you. But on the other end of the spectrum, though, I think it's important to just write out your workouts, because you want to come in with a plan. You know, you don't want to just kind of go based off from feel and kind of just think, okay, today I feel like doing this, today I feel like doing that. You know, so, you know, having structure is important, you know, organization. And leads me to my next point. Having a coach to, like, yes, it does make life a lot easier for you, but at the same time, too, a good coach will teach you how to lift, how to eat, or how to do all these things, so eventually you can be self-sufficient and do it on your own. So you're learning, you're teaching yourself how to fish instead of just buying the fish, essentially. Anyways, that's what a good coach would do. But anyways, yeah, that pretty much wraps up the video. Those are, like, basically my three reasons why I think you should be on a program. Hopefully you guys found this video helpful. If you guys like the video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. For more content like this, follow me on my journey. Make sure to subscribe. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Peace. And I got...